Welcome back to Subsistence Easy Mode. Wimpy Easy Mode. This is our campfire. This is the big grub tree, which I forgot I hadn't even hacked at it. So we had plenty of wood to get us through the night. That over there, well, somewhere, you can't really see it, that's the wolf that's been circling our camp all freaking night. Whatever, I'm eating wolf liver right now, buddy, just so you know, and we've got a gun. So, I got another grub, we got some wood, and I fabricated up this. We've got a bow now, and three arrows. Now, I can't really do anything to that wolf with these three arrows, but that's not what this is for. But I might be able to take it out. You can kill wolves with the bow and arrow, but it's super dangerous and stuff. I don't want to get infected and killed and stuff again. So, we're going to just basically hang out here for a little while the sun's rising. And the other thing I made was a pickaxe. So, we've got that pickaxe too, so we can get ore. Now, that wolf is making me nervous, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take what ash I can from here. And we're going to abandon this campfire. We can't get back to it. And we're going to hope, that as we head towards the rising sun, which is where we're going, we're going to just basically head directly in that direction to the east. We're going to hope we come across loot crates, and one of them has a match or biofuel in it. So I think I have one biofuel on me, but okay, that's ammo and nails, and both of those things are very, very welcome. Now, I've got this bow. With this bow, we're going to shoot chickens, I hope. Only got the three arrows. Oh, look, there's some ore right here. So now we can pull out our pickaxe, and that's right, we can pick at rocks, and there, we got zinc ore out of it. Whatever good that does us. Now, there's a pond down here, and there might be kelp in it, so we like swimming. We're going to have a bath here early morning, and see if there's kelp. You don't have to jump like that to get out of the water. I do, because I'm just weird. But yeah, no, we're going to just see if we can locate kelp. There we go, there's kelp. And we go up to the surface because that's where the air lives, and that helps us to live a little bit longer. So the sun is there. We can head that direction, but first we need to get more kelp. Kelp is very, very good. Alright. That is all the kelp I think we're going to find here. So we're going to get up out of here. Pray there are no wolves waiting to eat us when we exit the water. And so far, so good. Alright, back to the bow. No, let's get some more wood, because we don't really have much wood right now. Not much fed at all to the fire. Alright, so we're going to continue heading east, but we're not going to stare at the sun, because that's not really good for you to do that. Just kind of a heads up, guys. But we're going to grab a little more wood as we go. Because we want to be able to start building a base at some point. When I find a location, I want to do it. Okay, we're already at the fence. This fence, that means that's the end of the map. So, alright, well, let's go this way along the fence. So there's this pond at the edge of the map and the fence. I don't want to be at the edge of the map. I want to be more towards the middle of the map. So, yeah. Alright, well, we're going to cruise along here. Still got the wolf liver, and I don't want it to go bad on us, so we're going to go ahead and eat it now. And that'll put our protein all the way to the top, and we're going to eat this berry, one of them at least. And that'll bring us up there, and we need to hydrate a little bit, so we're going to drink that. And, all right, that'll put us in pretty good shape. Pretty good shape. So we can just sprint. Did I hear a bear? I don't know. But we're going to sprint around a little bit, because I want to cover a lot of ground today, and hopefully we'll find loot crates. I mean, maybe we won't up in this area. I don't know. This is a part of the map I haven't really explored very much, but there's a loot crate right there. Shotgun shells and 44 ammo. Now, if we can get some cloth, which you can get from killing bunnies, I don't know if you're aware of that, but okay, there's a freaking wolf right there by our fire. I wonder, do they he never came into my... Okay, look, there's two chickens up here. We're not going to worry about that wolf right now, because we want to kill that chicken and get its feathers and its meat. That, yes we can, and there's another chicken right next to it. We're gonna go for that one too, and right about there. Nice! Two shots, two kills. That'll give us two feathers, which will allow us to recreate our arrows that we just used to kill those chickens. That is freaking awesome. So, yeah, they're dead chickens right now. Actually, I've got four arrows. Okay, whatever. I've got four arrows left. I'm not going to worry about those chickens. We'll just carry around the chicken carcasses for a little while. Wow, that was super good. That was super good. But that campfire, there's nothing really I can do about that campfire. Not with that wolf there. I'm not going to tangle with that wolf. Just going to keep our eyes peeled for loot crates. We're going to kind of, I don't know if I should go too high into this up here, the snow line. We're just going to keep that to our left and continue on here. Because I know it's a wolf up there. I know in certain higher locations like that look very similar to this, you will encounter cougars. And cougars are the worst. They're like, they are super, super tough. Not something you want to take on at like day two or day three or whatever. So, we're going to hit this grub tree. They give you plenty of wood. And of course, the grub at the end of the whole thing. So, got that. I can find more of the fiber plants, though. That's... Okay, there's one over here. A little bit hard to see, but... Okay, there was another chicken. And I want to get that chicken. But I don't want it to lead me to a freaking cougar. Let's get our... No, not that. This bow. Where did that chicken... Chickens are weird because you'll hear them generally before you see them, but if you hear them, that's generally an indication that they saw you and they're taken off. So, which is okay, they don't run for very far. So if you see where they're going, you can generally... Okay, there he is. There he is. He saw me. He's taken off. So we're going to follow him a little bit, and man, I swear to God, he's going to lead us into something really bad. I just know it. Right, is that a... That's a bunny rabbit right there. Let's go for it. We need things that give us protein, and bunnies can do that. And this one also can give us cloth. Damn it, I waited too long. It's all right, we'll get him. I could shoot him on the move, maybe. I'm not very good he's taken off. Right, let's see. See, the rabbits are too fast, man. They're hard to follow. There's something up there, though. Yeah, I wanna kill these small game animals, but sometimes it's a bit of a challenge to get to them. What is this up here? That's our buddy. And he's moving on again. So let him get past the tree. Where is he? Yeah. Okay, come on. Let's get the shot. Like, right there. Got him. Alright, great. So we've got the three small game animals. Now we will need a campfire to cook these guys. But we can carry around the carcass for a little while before it goes bad, so it's not like immediate necessity to have the campfire, but it's something that we definitely want to be thinking about. There's a grub tree over here. And a freaking wolf. Of course, why wouldn't there be? And then there's a loot crate over on the other side too, so skirt around here. What? Where is the wolf that's growling? Is it that one over there? He looks like he's kind of peacing out. There might be one around this rock or something. No, I'm scared. Right over here. Okay, that wolf's not stalking us. See any over there? I do see a loot crate up there, though. All right, let's gonna grab this one, and then we're gonna go up for that other one. This is good. Nails are critically important. They're needed to make arrows with and to build anything with. So you always want to get these. The building supply crates are really good for that. And there's a ready-made plank. Are good. Okay, so we were heading in that general direction, but then we got a little bit sidetracked by stuff. You know, I guess right now I don't have an actual set destination, but right, that wolf's too close. I'm not going to bother with that tree. Oh, there's a chicken, though. We will bother with the chicken if we can catch it. Too close to them because they just run. And I'm a bad shot, so trying to shoot them while they're moving, that would pretty much mean I lose the arrow. So where are you, chicken? There you are. Okay, there we go. And got it. Wow, I haven't shot yet. That is freaking amazing. Trust me, that's not how it usually goes for me. So maybe it's just because I know I have so few arrows and it's really critical, so I'm making sure I've got just the perfect shot before I release. But yeah, that's how you should usually do it, I think, anyway. Let's go ahead and pick up this tree a little bit. Our stamina bar is totally full. Our health is up. Everything is fine in that regard. And I just want to keep looking for loot chests. Those loot crates are the best. They are the best. So I have no idea really where we're going. We're just wandering. In our wanderings, if I find an area that looks really appealing to build at, I will. But I am enjoying just looking around. So the downside is the fire thing. You know, that is going to be a problem. if you find enough loot crates that have either matches or biofuel, we'll be okay. You know, we'll be alright. But it is important to have a base where you can... What was that? I heard something. It is important to have a base where you can actually set up a cooking stove and create your own biofuel, which will allow you to make fire starters, you know, at your leisure. But, yeah, there's... Let's go down. Let's get out of the hills a little bit. But isn't this map freaking gorgeous? I mean, look at it. It's got kind of natural trails and stuff like that. And there's, you know, obviously there's the wildlife all over the place. And the trees and grasses and everything is beautiful. Everything is so beautiful. But we want to find loot crates. It's one thing to admire the beauty of the landscape. It's another thing to get loot. I love loot. Fiber is going to be critical to us too, because man, you can go through so much cordage. You have to make cordage in order to make any structures, like walls and foundations and all that stuff. It takes cordage, and the cordage requires 2 fiber per. So let's come up here and we're going to harvest this. These are sometimes tricky to get to, and you honestly almost always have to just crouch down in order to get them. So, let's just look around here and see if we see more. But that one was a good one. That was iron ore, and iron ore is super valuable for making stuff. Okay, here's that other place where the other fire pit was. So, since I know it's out... Thought it was here, wasn't that? Did I build a fireplace here? Is it over here? Oh, it's over here. Yeah, it's out. I mean, we could relight it, right? I like this freaking pond. Maybe this would be a good place for a base. I just don't see, like, landmarks around that make it easy to get to. These aren't going to last forever, these chickens and stuff. So we're going to need to cook them up. And I'm thinking probably sooner rather than later. We do have time to explore a little bit. But I'm thinking we'll come back to that campfire. There's a freaking wolf and stuff over there. Maybe we'll just check around the pond a little bit and see... Then we can come back and use that campfire again. But man, there are lots of wolves and things around here. Yeah, I'm looking for loot crates right now. If we see chickens or rabbits, I'll shoot at them, but there's a freaking bear over there. I mean, mean, you know, if we were to build in an area like this, there's certainly plenty of trees, right? But there aren't really grub trees. So the fishing, we'd have to go out and find lots of grubs elsewhere. I don't know. We might build over here, though. Well, let's just explore. Let's just look around. Now, there are these other type of crate. They're locked crates. You have to have lock picks to open them. And I think you find those mostly in areas that you might also find cougar in. And I'm thinking, what a cool place to build that would be, right? Okay, it would be super dangerous, but if you could find lock crates right near your base pretty regularly, that's where all the best stuff comes out of. And I would kind of like to do that. So maybe we will. There's a bear over there. Well, I'm not seeing very many loot crates around here. It's not to say that they wouldn't be spawning here. It may just be luck of the draw kind of deal. Well, for today, I guess we could just continue to search around here, see what kind of loot crates we might find, and that kind of stuff. Nice. Iron ore. We like it. Now, we'll have to build a refinery to refine the ore, but it's nice to get a little bit of it. The loot crates can spawn everywhere, so yeah, it's just without the BCU unit, it's very, very difficult to locate a base that's not like either along the fence somewhere where you can just follow the fence line, or near some big landmark. Now these rocks are clearly landmarky, and so is this pond, but, you know, in relation to what on the map? This guy up by making, we don't have any matches, so we have to make a fire starter kit, and we can craft that up right there. And I want to make a little more cordage. Alright, so we'll get the fire starter kit. We've got some wood. We'll put this wood in there. Take that. Put that in there. Light this up, and then we're going to go ahead and butcher these chickens and get them cooked. Because otherwise, they're going to go bad on us. And we'll do this bunny. And now you'll notice my inventory is filling up here. So we're going to have a base with storage crate that we can store stuff in. Otherwise, you know, we're not going to be able to keep all the loots. So let's go ahead and fill up our thingy here. And once these are cooked up, we'll go ahead and boil up that water also. We need veggies pretty badly here, so I'm going to eat all three of those. And we're going to have to eat a kelp also. I think the kelp, let's see, protein, what does that even say? I can't. Protein 0, fruit and veg 9. Yeah, and it makes you a little bit thirsty. It solves a bit of your hunger, but makes you a little bit thirsty. So, alright. Well, we're just going to eat up this chicken. And the rabbit. These don't do a whole lot individually, but if you have a few of them like that, it really, really does the trick for you. So, then this one, we're going to go ahead and butcher it. I'm going to wait a little while before we cook it. And we're going to boil our water. Let's do that. And then let's eat another kelp. Eat one of those. That'll bring us up here. Now, you've got spoilage timers on a lot of the food items, not berries, just mainly the meat, right? Now the chicken itself can go bad, or the like raw, butchered part of the chicken can go bad, or the cooked chicken go bad. Now I don't know this for sure, but it seems to be that like the chicken has its own timer. And if you wait long enough, just before it goes bad, and then you butcher it, then you've got the meat, and it has its own separate timer that you can wait with the raw meat for quite a while then before you cook it. And then, after you cook it, that cooked meat has its own timer. So you can extend the life of that stuff by, just waiting to butcher, and then waiting to cook, and then waiting to eat. But I could be wrong about all of that. So, but I do know that the meat spoils. So, that is that. But we are now looking great on pretty much everything. Let's go ahead and refill this. If I can find the water in the dark. There we go. boil it up again and cook it up again. And we will have a full canteen for the morning. So at this point, we're going to wait out the night. And I'll just say thank you so much for joining us. I hope you're enjoying this. If you are, please smash the like button. Leave me any comments, tips, tricks, recommendations, or death threats. Subscribe if you haven't. And we will talk with all of you again very, very soon.